Welcome to IVC. We look forward to helping you live as healthy and active of a lifestyle as possible. Our team is committed to providing you with state-of-the-art personalized care. IVC is nationally accredited with board-certified physicians who are fellowship-trained in vascular and interventional radiology. Interventional radiologists are on the cutting edge of clinical advances and use the latest image-guided technologies in the treatment of many medical conditions that once required open surgery. Their expertise includes management of arterial and venous disease, including peripheral arterial disease, varicose veins, blood clots, and other vascular disorders. You will also work closely with our experienced nurse practitioners, nurses, physician assistants, specialized sonographers, medical assistants, and office staff. IVC is committed to helping you through each step of your care, and we want you to be as informed as possible about your condition. We hope this video will provide you with important additional information to help you understand pelvic venous congestion, also commonly referred to as pelvic congestion syndrome. This condition falls under a broader range of pelvic venous disorders, which are a known but often unrecognized cause of chronic pelvic pain. What is pelvic congestion syndrome? Pelvic congestion syndrome is an important but often unrecognized cause of chronic pelvic pain. It can exist on its own, or it can exist alongside other pelvic abnormalities, such as endometriosis, uterine fibroids, or other pathologies. To explain pelvic congestion syndrome, it helps to understand the purpose of veins in the body. Veins return blood to the heart. Many veins have valves designed to help return blood to the heart by preventing backflow of blood in the vein. When these valves don't work or deeper veins are obstructed, blood pools in the congested pelvic veins, resulting in vein distension and increased pressure around the uterus, ovaries, and vulva, which may cause chronic pelvic pain. Varicose pelvic veins most often develop when the valves in the ovarian veins are not working correctly. Occasionally, critical deeper veins are obstructed, which causes blood to pool and distend pelvic veins. This condition is known as pelvic venous congestion or pelvic congestion syndrome. Research shows that an estimated 30% of patients with chronic pelvic pain actually have pelvic congestion syndrome, or PCS, as the primary cause of their pelvic pain. The majority of these patients are women under the age of 45 and are still in their childbearing years. Although the causes of pelvic congestion syndrome are complex and poorly understood, there are several commonly recognized associations, which include genetic predisposition, female gender, multiple pregnancies, iliac vein obstruction. What are the symptoms of pelvic congestion syndrome? Women suffering from pelvic venous disorders often describe pelvic bloating, low back pain, increased urinary frequency, and dull pelvic achiness or heaviness that is worsened by prolonged standing, pregnancy, sexual intercourse, menstruation, or ovulation. Painful menstrual cycles are often associated with referred pain in the legs. There may also be visible varicose veins in the groin, buttocks, and upper thigh. How is pelvic congestion syndrome diagnosed? Unfortunately, pelvic venous congestion often goes unrecognized and untreated. Symptoms, physical exam, and specialized ultrasound techniques have a high combined predictive value in diagnosing pelvic venous disorders. The ability of duplex ultrasound to image in real time makes it an important tool in the evaluation of possible pelvic venous congestion. Because there are several potential causes of chronic pelvic pain, medical professionals may also need to conduct additional exams, including CT, MRI, and laparoscopy. Although laparoscopy, CT, and MRI can be used to rule out other causes of pelvic pain, a pelvic exam and specialized pelvic duplex ultrasound are the best and least invasive tools for diagnosing pelvic venous congestion. How is pelvic congestion syndrome treated? Once a patient is diagnosed with PCS, this condition can often be successfully treated with a minimally invasive procedure called pelvic vein embolization. Pelvic vein embolization requires little or no downtime and is performed in an outpatient setting. Occasionally, a compressed iliac vein may contribute to venous congestion, and a stent may be indicated to help restore normal flow. The procedure requires little or no downtime and is performed in an outpatient setting. In properly selected patients, embolization provides significant relief of symptoms in about 85% of patients who are treated. Under ultrasound and X-ray guidance, your treating physician will guide a small diameter flexible catheter or tube about the size of a strand of spaghetti into the affected ovarian and/or internal iliac veins. Injection of a liquid contrast agent allows the interventional radiologist to visualize the abnormal refluxing pelvic veins and then close the veins using a combination of tiny metal coils and sclerosynt. Closing the diseased veins generally relieves the aching pelvic pressure related to distended pelvic veins. In occasional cases where a significantly narrowed or obstructed iliac vein contributes to pelvic vein distension, opening the obstructed or narrowed vein with stenting can also help relieve symptoms. After treatment, the catheter is removed and a small dressing is then applied. Patients typically return to normal activity the same day following the procedure. The advantages of embolization. The advantages of embolization include little or no downtime required, performed as an outpatient, minimally invasive but highly effective, short recovery. Here are a few treatment tips to keep in mind as you prepare for your embolization procedure. Wear comfortable clothing to the procedure. Eat a light meal the evening before your procedure. Don't eat or drink less than 6 hours before treatment, unless directed by your doctor. Over-the-counter pain medication is typically all that is needed after the procedure. While recovering, stay active, but avoid heavy lifting. Reach out to your treating doctor with any questions or concerns. Your treatment plan may be adjusted from what was originally prescribed, depending on what we see in follow-up evaluations. Varicose vein treatment is often an ongoing process with need for long-term follow-up. We'll work closely with you to help manage your varicose veins and give you the best outcome possible. Associated treatment risks. As with any medical procedure, and in spite of our efforts to keep you safe, there are known potential associated risks with the treatment of pelvic venous congestion. Although uncommon, these risks include infection, bleeding, deep and superficial vein blood clot formation, coil migration, stent migration, or occlusion, and persistent or worsening symptoms. Infection risk is minimized by our use of strict sterile techniques. You will be instructed to keep the vein access sites clean and dry for several days after your procedure to prevent infection and scarring. Antibiotics may be prescribed in select cases to further reduce infection risk. Please let us know if you have undergone heart valve or joint replacement surgery, or if you have other conditions that may require pre-treatment antibiotics. Bleeding is usually minimal and can typically be controlled by applying local pressure. If you are taking a blood thinner for another condition, we will typically have you stay on it during treatment. Please let us know if you are taking any blood thinners, including aspirin. The risk of developing deep vein blood clots in legs, DVT, or lungs, PE, is less than 1% for most patients. DVT and PE risk is higher if you have a history of previous DVT or PE, are taking oral contraceptives, undergoing hormone replacement therapy, or if you have a known clotting disorder. Please let us know if any of these situations apply to you. Stroke is a rare potential complication of venous embolization. Although a permanent neurological deficit would be extremely unusual, patients may infrequently describe transient headaches and visual changes that typically resolve within a few minutes. Please let us know if you have a history of migraines, stroke, or cardiac defects, such as a patent foramen ovale, as these conditions may be associated with increased risk of stroke. Coil migration is rare. We take precautions to size the coils for optimal stability and effectiveness, and they are used to occlude the diseased veins. Stent migration or occlusion is a rare potential complication. In cases where a stent may be required to open an obstructed iliac vein, we take precautions to size stents for optimal stability and effectiveness in order to optimize blood flow from your pelvis. And finally, in spite of undergoing a technically successful procedure, your symptoms may persist, reoccur, or even worsen. For most patients, however, the benefits of treatment outweigh the potential risks. Please let us know if you have any other questions regarding the potential risks of PCS treatment. Conclusion. Pelvic venous congestion can impair your lifestyle and result in significant disability. With the help of our team of vascular and interventional specialists and state-of-the-art diagnostic and treatment tools, you can generally achieve significant relief of symptoms. While we cannot alter many of the risk factors that predispose you to developing pelvic venous congestion, we'll do our best to help you manage your condition. You'll have time to consult with us in greater detail before any procedure we perform. If you have any questions or concerns, or if you experience a complication following a procedure, we want to hear from you as soon as possible. Our providers are on call 24 hours a day and can be reached after hours through our office number at 801-379-6700. If you'd like more information about your specific treatment process, visit iVein.com or ask one of our providers. We hope this video has helped you better understand pelvic venous congestion and the associated risks and benefits of treatment. If you have any questions or concerns at any time, please ask one of our providers or office staff members. Thank you for your attention. We look forward to working with you.